Hey, today's question is what to do if I am bored. I'm not saying you should do exactly what I'm about to suggest, but here are a few ideas I quickly gathered. First, you could go for achievement points and rewards. As you can see, at 10,000 you even get 400 of gems. That's pretty cool. Also, there is a quite useful indication of the stuff you are about to complete, like for me, Windrider's Lair. And all I need to do is kill some more Windriders. If you will complete one of the three, the other one will pop up. Or you can select whatever you want, for instance Tequatl or Drakkar, and go for it. Second, you could go for mastery points as well. As you can see, I have insights that are not completed yet. I'm lazier than I thought. Well, that's one more thing that you can do. Third, you can check your inventory and bank. I'm sure there will be some stuff that will be quite interesting. For example, Keys of Great Nightmares. I think that's for the Labyrinth. Underneath Silver Wastes. I'm not sure. Rusted Keys. These are for Sunken Chests. I know this one. But I've never done it. Yes. These Roland's Key Fragments. I have two. I tried to delete these, but it said it's a one-time thing, so I kept them. And as you can see, I need two more. I should really get rid of those by getting two more. What do we have here? Broken Kaladbalg. You might as well restore it and get Ascended Weapon, or all of them, as you wish. I think actually I should do that too, someday. My next suggestion is to try a game mode that you were not so interested in previously, because you might actually like it. Like for me, it's World v World or Strike Missions. Of course, I did a few, but just a few. Also, let's not forget such things as leveling a new character on your own, map exploration, getting a mount that you don't have, and so on. My next suggestion would be to change the appearance of your character. Like I did with my Necro. Now I think that it looks actually half decent. And all this thanks to GW Style website. You can go check it out for some ideas, and it really helps to freshen up things a little bit. Next, you could try a completely different build. For example, if you were geared towards damage all the time, you can try attrition build for a completely different playstyle. Or if you wear power, you could always try Condi. It also gives you a feeling that something is fresh and new and sort of revives faded love for your character. Lastly, if you are sort of a loner like myself, you could actually try to do more stuff with your guild. I'm sure there are some events that your guildmates are trying to do like each week, like guild missions and so on and so on. So you might as well try to be a little bit more social. And of course, vice versa. And if your guild do not fulfill your needs, you can actually be in few guilds at the same time. And multi-guilding is not a bad thing at all. I mean, each guild can bring you a piece of the pie that the other one doesn't have, right? And everyone has some sort of a daily routine, yeah, but it doesn't really have to be a job, and nothing will happen if you will skip some things once or twice. I mean, it's up to you actually to mix things up and make them interesting. Alrighty, these were my quick suggestions. Of course, there are plenty other things to do. You are the one to decide. I think the beauty and the biggest appeal of this game is that it's really, really diverse, and there are plenty new aspects of the game for you to discover. So, that's all I had. I hope this helps. As usual, I will thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.